What's up, YouTube? My name is Riley McKibben. This is my brother Madison. This is Taylor Crabb. And today, we're going to teach you how to hit like this.
First set, glad you hit this on, man. And he set it. And it bounces out into the Hudson. When Hudson
Riverline. Taylor Crabb is 5'11.
Whoa. I'm legit 6 feet.
You're not 6 feet.
Wait. I have a tape measure.
Yeah. What's the verdict? Okay, so he is 6 feet.
Told you.
And weighs roughly about 160 pounds.
Yep, that's about right.
Taylor Crabb's nickname, which we gave him about 20 years ago, is The Bug. Why do we call you The Bug?
I was always just the smallest person in my family and around my friends. All you guys used to just smash me on the volleyball court and throw me around and bully me.
Not bully.
Oh, that's enough.
With all that being said, The Bug can bounce.
So it's not because he can jump the highest, and it's certainly not because he's the strongest. It's because the mechanics of his arm swing.
So in today's episode, we're gonna analyze exactly that and teach you exactly what he's doing so you can start hitting harder, higher, and maybe even more importantly, save that shoulder. You're done, help me move this couch. All right, so last week we gave you Taylor's four-step hitting footwork, gearing up for the jump and swing. You can find that in a link below.
So today we're gonna give you another four-step process on his arm swing. And make sure to watch the entire video. So if you have any questions, you can add them into the comments below.
Chapter number one, the Nike Swish. A great visual cue for how you wanna hold your arms is the Nike Swish. Bing. So we want that left arm up really high. A lot of kids forget to do this and leave their arm dangling by the side, which we end up missing out on added torque later on in the arm swing. So we want our right arm to go straight up and back immediately. Elbow staying above our ear, forming about a 90 degree angle from hand to shoulder. And that is our initial arm placement, better known as the Nike Swish. Swish, swish.
Chapter number two, the full body whip. So we want to think of the body as an entire whip. The handle of the whip being at the hips, and then the edge of the whip being at your fingertips. Whoosh. Once he decides it's time to initiate his arm swing, he uses his entire body like a whip. Starting with his hips, he jolts his right hip forward. This hip jolt elongates his core, which he then quickly contracts, whipping the next section, his right pec, forward.
Simultaneously, Taylor increases his torque by pulling his left arm down towards his side, further accelerating that right pec forward. So during the swing, you can either tuck your left elbow down towards your side, bending at the elbow, slightly tilting your body to the left to increase elevation with your right hand.
Or you can think about driving that left palm down towards the ground, which facilitates acceleration through the hitting arm.
By keeping his hitting arm nice and relaxed, his elbow naturally trails behind his chest. Think of it like a rubber band. The longer we can stretch it, the more it'll snap.
The more it'll snap! Lastly, is that elbow is propelled forward up above his head. His right hand, which has been loose and relaxed the entire time, seen by the slightly limp wrist and bent fingers, and begins to open up naturally from the intense acceleration, contacting the ball with a fully open hand.
Note that both his wrist and elbow are completely locked out, and his upper body is upright, slightly tilting forward, contacting the ball just slightly in front of his head.
Right after he contacts the ball, he curls his fingers in the direction he wants the ball to go, then breaks his wrist, next his elbow, finally finishing with his right hand in his left pocket.
It's important to know that although all these movements are happening very fast and may seem like they're happening at the same time, they're actually happening in separate sequential order. Because Taylor is so elastic, he can relax his entire body and quickly contract one muscle group to accelerate another and another and another, compounding acceleration on top of one another. Chapter three, core values.
Taylor believes that 70% of his power comes from his core.
Since your core transmits the power from your jump through your core to your torso and shoulder, if your core is like jello and not even engaged, you risk injuring your shoulder because you end up only using your shoulder.
By twisting or torquing your core, you not only generate more force, but your contact point is higher. That's opposed to piking, whereas you pike, you decrease the use of your core and your contact point is lower because you have to come down further to contact the ball.
Piking is bad.
Number four, grunting is good. Connecting your breath and your arm swing is not only important, but highly encouraged.
On the jump, we inhale, exhaling when we initiate the arm swing. Inhaling elongates our abs, obliques, and chest. Yet by holding our breath, all our muscles stay elongated, losing out on all that snap. Think of it like stretching out a rubber band and holding it there. It won't snap, but exhaling facilitates that snap. And when we exhale really fast, sometimes that comes out as a grunt or a yell. If you don't believe us, watch a match or even a single point of tennis played by Serena Williams, or better yet, listen to a boxing match. All those tss are for a reason.
All right, so that's our video on arm swing mechanics. And I know we went over a lot of information, that being the Nike swoosh, you know, the full body whip, core values, and grunting is good. But if you have any questions, please leave them down in the comments below and we'll get to them probably by the end of the day. Most likely.
So tomorrow.
If you enjoyed our videos, you know, click the subscribe and check all the other ones out. All right, thanks.
See you guys.